In my 19th year, on my own initiative and at my own expense, I raised an army with which I set free the state, which was oppressed by the domination of a faction. For that reason, the Senate enrolled me in its order by laudatory resolutions, when Gaius Pensa and Aulus Hirtius were consuls, assigning me the place of a consul in the giving of opinions, and gave me the imperium. With me as propraetor, it ordered me, together with the consuls, to take care lest any detriment befall the state. But the people made me consul in the same year, when the consuls each perished in battle, and they made me a triumvir for the settling of the state. I drove the men who slaughtered my feather into exile with a legal order, punishing their crime. And afterwards, when they waged war on the state, I concurred them in two battles. I have then waged war, civil and foreign, on the earth and sea in the whole wide world. And as victor, I spared all the citizens who sought pardon. As for foreign nations, those which I was able to safely forgive, I preferred to preserve than to destroy. About 500,000 Roman citizens were sworn to me. I owned something more than 300,000 of them into colonies, and I returned them to their cities after their stipend had been earned. And I assigned all of them fields, or gave them money for their military service. I captured 600 ships, in addition to those smaller than triremes. Twice I triumphed with an ovation, and three times I enjoyed a curule triumph, and 21 times I was named emperor. When the Senate decreed more triumphs for me, I sat out from all of them. I placed the laurel from the fasces in the capital, when the vows which I pronounced in each war had been fulfilled. On account of things successfully done by me and through my officers under my auspices on earth and sea. The Senate decreed 55 times that there be sacrifices to the immortal gods. Moreover, there were 890 days on which the Senate decreed there would be sacrifices. In my triumphs, kings and nine children of kings were led before my chariot. I had been consul 13 times when I wrote this, and I was in the 37th year of tribunician power. When the dictatorship was offered to me both in my presence and absence by the people, and Senate, when Marcus Marcellus and Lucius Aurantius were consuls, I did not accept it. I did not abet the curatorship of grain and the head of the food shortage, which I so arranged that within a few days I freed the entire city from the prison fear and danger by my own expense and administration. When the annual and perpetual consulate was then again offered to me, I did not accept it. When Marcus Vinicius and Quintus Lacretius were consuls, then again when Publius Lentulus and Gaius Lentulus were, and third when Pallas Fabius Maximus and Quintus Tugere were. Although the Senate and Roman people consented that I alone be made curator of the laws and customs of the highest power, I received no magistracy offered contrary to the customs of the ancestors. What the Senate then wanted to accomplish through me, I did through tribunician power, and five times on my own accord I both requested and received from the Senate a collegium such power. I was triumvir for the settling of the state for 10 continuous years. I was first of the Senate up to that day on which I wrote this, for 40 years. I was high priest augur, one of the 15 for the performance of rites, one of the 7 of the sacred feasts, brother of Arbus, fellow of Titus and Fetchel. When I was consul the fifth time, I increased the number of patricians by order of the people in Senate. I read the roll of the Senate 3 times, and in my 6th consulate I made a census of the people with Marcus Agrippa as my colleague. Conducted a lustrum after a 41-year gap, in which lustrum were counted 4,063,000 heads of Roman citizens. Then again, with consular imperium, I conducted a lustrum alone when Gaius Censorinus and Gaius Asinius were consuls, in which lustrum were counted 4,233,000 heads of Roman citizens. And a third time, with consular imperium, I conducted a lustrum with my son Tiberius Caesar as colleague. When Sextus Pompeius and Sextus Appius were consuls, in which lustrum were counted 4,937,000 of the heads of Roman citizens. By new laws passed with my sponsorship, I restored many traditions of the ancestors, which were falling into disuse and orage.
And myself, I handed on precedents of many things to be imitated in later generations.
The Senate decreed that vows be undertaken for my health by the consuls and priests every 5th year.
In fulfillment of these vows, they often celebrated games for my life, several times the 4 house colleges of priests, several times the consuls. Also, both privately and as a city, all the citizens unanimously and continuously prayed at all the shrines for my health.
By a Senate decree, my name was included in the cellular hymn, and it was sanctified by law, both that I would be sacrosanct forever, and that as long as I would love, that the tribunician power would be mine.
I was unwilling to be high priest in the place of my loving colleague,
When the people offered me the priesthood, which my father had, I refused it.
And I received the priesthood after several years with the death of him who had occupied it since the opportunity of the civil disturbance, with a multitude flocking together out of Olivet to my election. So Zuckerberg had never before been in wrong when Publius Sulpicius and Gaius Valdius were consuls. The Senate consecrated the altar for Chung to bring her back before the temples of honor and virtue at the campaigning gate for my return, on which it ordered the priests and Vestal virgins to offer yearly sacrifices on the day when I had returned to the city from Syria.
When Quintus Lacridius and Marcus Vinicius were consuls, and it named the day of Vestal after my cognomen.
By the authority of the Senate, a part of the praetors and tribunes of the plebs, with Consul Quintus Lacridius and the leading men,
was sent to meet me in Campania, which honor had been decreed for no one but me until that time.
When I returned to Rome from Spain and Gaul, having successfully accomplished matters in those provinces, when Tiberius Junior and Publius Quintilius were consuls, the Senate voted to consecrate the altar of August Peace in the field of Mars for my return, on which it ordered the magistrates and priests and Vestal virgins to offer annual sacrifices. Our ancestors, Longinus Quirinus, to be closed when throughout all the rule of the Roman people by land and sea, peace had been secured through victory.
Although before my birth it had been closed twice and all of them recorded memory from the founding of the city, the Senate voted three times in my principate that it be closed. When my sons Gaius and Lucius Caesar, whom fortune stole from me as youths, were 14, the Senate and Roman people made them consuls designated on behalf of my honor.
So that they would enter that magistracy after 5 years, and the Senate decreed that on that day, when they were led into the forum, they would be included in public councils. Moreover, the Romanites together named each of them first of the youth and gave them shields and spears. I paid to the Roman plebs Echus 300 per man from my father as well, and in my own name gave Echus 400 from the spoils of war when I was consul for the fifth time.
Furthermore, I again paid out a public gift of Echus 400 per man in my tenth consulate from my own patrimony.
And when consul for the 11th time, 12 doles of grain personally bought were measured out, and in my 12th year of tribunician power, I gave HS 400 per man for the third time. And these public gifts of mine never reached fewer than 250,000 men.
In my 18th year of tribunician power, as consul for the 12th time, I gave to 320,000 plebs of the city HS 240 per man. And when consul the fifth time, I gave from my worst spoils to colonies of my soldiers each HS 1,000 per man, about 120,000 men in the colonies received this triumphal public gift.
Consul for the 13th time, I give HS 240 to the plebs who then received the public grain. There were a few more than 200,000. I paid the town's money for the fields, which I had assigned to soldiers in my fourth consulate, and then when Marcus Crassus and Gaius Lentulus Augur were consuls.
The sum was about HS 600 million, which I paid out for Italian estates, and about HS 260 million, which I paid for provincial fields.
I was first and alone who did this among all who founded military colonies in Italy or the provinces according to the memory of my age.
And afterwards, when Tiberius Nero and Gaius Piso were consuls, and likewise when Gaius Antistius and Decius were consuls.
And when Gaius Calvisius and Lucius Passionus were consuls, and when Lucius Lentulus and Marcus Messala were consuls. And when Lucius Canidius and Quintus Fabricius were consuls, I paid out rewards in cash to the soldiers whom I led into their towns when their service was completed, and in this venture I have spent about at just 400 million. Four times I helped the senatorial treasury with my money, so I offered at just 150 million to those who were in charge of the treasury. And when Marcus Lepidus and Lucius Laurentius were consuls, I offered at just 170 million for my patrimony to the military treasury,
which was funded by my advice and from which rewards were given to soldiers who had served 20 or more times.
From that year when Gaius and Publius Lentulus were consuls, when the taxes fell short, I got contributions of grain and money from my granary and patrimony, sometimes to 100,000 men, sometimes to many more. I built the Senate house in the Chalcidicum, which adjoins it, the Temple of Apollo on the Palatine with porticos, the Temple of Divine Julius the Lupercal.
The portico of the Flaminian Circus, which I allowed to be called by the name Octavian after he who had earlier built in the same place the state box of the Great Circus.
The temple on the Capitoline of Jupiter Subdura and Jupiter Thunder, the temple of Quirinus, the temples of Minerva and Queen Juno and Jupiter Liberator on the Aventine, the temple of the Lars at the top of the Holly Street, the temple of the gods of the Penates on the Velian, the temple of Youth, and the temple of the Great Mother on the Palatine. I rebuilt the Capitol on the Vitter Pompeii, each work at enormous cost, without any inscription of my name. I rebuilt aqueducts in many places that had decayed with age, and I doubled the capacity of the Martian aqueduct by sending a new spring into its channel.
I completed the Forum of Julius, and the basilica which he built between the Temple of Castor and the Temple of Saturn, works begun and almost finished by my father.
When the same basilica was burned with fire, I expanded its grounds, and I began it under an inscription of the name of my sons.
And if I should not complete it alive, I ordered it to be completed by my heirs. And so for the sixth time, I rebuilt 82 temples of the gods in the city by the authority of the Senate, omitting nothing which ought to have been rebuilt at that time.
And so for the seventh time, I rebuilt the Flaminian rod from the city to Ariminum, and all the bridges except the Mulvian and Minucian. I built the temple of Mars Altar on private ground, and the Forum of Augustus from horse balls.
I built the theater at the Temple of Apollo on ground largely bought from private owners, under the name of Marcus Marcellus, my son-in-law. I consecrated gifts from horse balls in the capital, and in the Temple of Divine Julius, in the Temple of Apollo,
in the Temple of Vesta, and in the Temple of Mars Altar, which cost me about S100 million. I sent back gold crowns weighing 35,000 to the towns and colonies of Italy, which had been contributed for my triumphs, and later, however many times I was named emperor, refused gold crowns from the towns and colonies which they equally kindly decreed, and before they decreed them. 3 times I give shows of gladiators under my name, and 5 times under the name of my sons and grandsons, and these shows about 10,000 men fought. Twice I furnished under my name spectacles of athletes gathered from everywhere, and 3 times under my grandson's name.
I celebrated games under my name 4 times, and furthermore in the place of other magistrates 23 times.
As master of the college, I celebrated the secular games for the college of the 15, with my colleague Marcus Agrippa, whom Gaius Fernius and Gaius Silanus were consuls. And so for the 13th time, I celebrated the first games of Maz, which after that time thereafter in following years by Senate decree and allowed, the consuls were to celebrate.
26 times, under my name or that of my sons and grandsons, I give the people hunts of African beasts in the circus, in the open, or in the amphitheater.
And then about 3,500 beasts were killed. I gave the people a spectacle of unable battle in the place across the Tiber where the Grove of the Caesars is now, with the ground excavated in length 1,800 feet. In width 1,200, which 30 big ships by reams or triremes, but many smaller fought among themselves, and these ships about 3,000 men fought in addition to the rowers. In the temples of all the cities of the province of Asia as victor, I replaced the ornaments which he with whom I fought the war had possessed privately after he despoiled the temples.
Silver statues of me, on foot, on horseback, and standing in a chariot, were erected in about 80 cities, which I myself remote.
And from the money I placed golden offerings in the temple of Apollo under my name, and to those who paid me the honor of the statues to me, I restored peace to the sea from pirates. In that slave war I handed over to their masters for the infliction of punishments about 30,000 captured, who had fled their masters and taken up arms against the state.
All Italy swore allegiance to me voluntarily, and demanded me as leader of the war, which I won action.
That the provinces of Gaul, Spain, Africa, Sicily, and Sardinia swore the same allegiance. And those who then fought under my standard were more than 700 senators, among whom 83 were made consuls either before or after, up to the day this was written, and about 170 were made priests. I extended the borders of all the provinces of the Roman people which neighbored nations not subject to our rule. I restored peace to the provinces of Gaul and Spain, likewise Germany, which includes the ocean from Cadiz to the mouth of the river Elbe. I brought peace to the Alps from the region which is near the Adriatic Sea to the Tuscan, with no unjust war waged against any nation. I sold my ships on the ocean from the mouth of the Rhine to the East region up to the borders of the Cimbri, where the Roman had gone before that time by land or sea. In the Cimbri and the Charidias and the Semnans and the other Germans in the same territory, so by envoys the friendship of me and of the Roman people.
By my order and Aspes's 2 armies were led at about the same time into Ethiopia and into that part of Arabia which is called Happy.
And the troops of each nation of enemies were slaughtered in battle and many towns captured. They penetrated into Ethiopia all the way to the town Nabata, which is near Namara, and into Arabia all the way to the border of the Sabae, advancing to the town Mariba.
I did Egypt to the rule of the Roman people. When Artaxerxes, king of Greater Armenia, was killed, though I could have made it a province, I preferred by the example of our elders
to hand over that kingdom to Tigranes, son of King Artavasdes, and grandson of King Tigranes, through Tigris Nero, who was then my stepson. In the same nation, after revolting and rebelling and subdued through my son Gaius, I handed over to be ruled by King Ariobarzanes, son of Artabazus, king of the Medes.
and after his death to his son Artavastes. And when he was killed, I sent Tigranes, who came from the royal clan of the Armenians, into the role.
I recovered all the provinces which lie across the Adriatic to the east and Cyrene, with kings now possessing them in large part, and Sicily and Sardinia, which had been occupied earlier in the slave war. I founded colonies of soldiers in Africa, Sicily, Macedonia, each Spain, Greece, Asia, Syria, Narbonne-Gaul, and Pisidia, and furthermore had 28 colonies founded in Italy under my authority, which were very populous and crowded while I lived. I recovered from Spain, Gaul, and Dalmatia the many military standards lost through other leaders after defeating the enemies. I compelled the Parthians to return to me the spoils and standards through Roman armies and as Cyprians to seek the friendship of the Roman people. Furthermore, I placed those standards in the sanctuary of the temple of Mars altar. It is for the tribes of the Pannonians. Before my principate, no army of the Roman people had entered their land. When they were conquered through Tiberius Nero, who's then my stepson and emissary, I subjected them to the rule of the Roman people and extended the borders of Illyricum to the shores of the river Danube. On the near side of it, the army of the Dacians was conquered and overcome under my auspices. And then my army led across the Danube, forced the tribes of the Dacians to bear the rule of the Roman people.
My emissaries from the Indian kings were often sent to me, which had not been seen before that time by any Roman leader.
The bastard of the Scythians and the Sarmatians who were on the side of the river Don and the kings further away. And the kings of the Albanians, of the Iberians, and of the Medes sought our friendship through emissaries. And to me were sent supplications by kings of the Parthians, Tiridates and leader Phrates, son of King Phrates, of the Medes, Artavastes, of the Idiobani Artaxares, of the Britons, Demobilinus and Tincomius, of the Sugambri, Melu of the Marcomanian Suebi, King Phrates of the Parthians, son of Ardias, sent all his sons and grandsons into Italy to me, though defeated in your war, but seeking our friendship through the pledges of his children. And in my principate, many other peoples experienced the faith of the Roman people, of whom nothing previously existed of embassies or interchange of friendship with the Roman people. The nations of the Parthians and Medes received from me the first kings of those nations which they served by emissaries.
The Parthians, Phanomius, son of King Phrates, grandson of King Ardias. The Medes, Eribursans, son of King Artavastes, grandson of King Eribursans.
And my sixth and seventh consulates, after putting out the civil war, having obtained all things by universal consent, I handed over the state from my power to the dominion of the Senate and Roman people.
And for this merit of mine, by a Senate decree,
I was called Augustus, and the doors of my temple were publicly clothed with laurel. And a civic crown was fixed over my door and a gold shield placed in the Julian Senate house. And the inscription of that shield testified to the virtue, mercy, justice, and piety for which the Senate and Roman people gave it to me.
After that time, I exceeded all in influence, but I had no greater power than the others who were colleagues with me in each magistracy.
When I administered my 13th consulate, the Senate and Equestrian Order and Roman people all called me father of the country and voted that the same be inscribed in the vestibule of my temple, in the Julian Senate house, and in the form of Augustus under the chariot which had been placed there for me by a decision of the Senate.
When I wrote this, I was 76 years old.